I'm going to let you in on a little secret. Adrenal fatigue is not just adrenal fatigue. Hi, I'm Dr. Andrew Neville. I specialize in treating adrenal fatigue and have for almost 20 years now, but I'm here to kind of debunk some misinformation with regard to adrenal fatigue. The most accurate name to call adrenal fatigue would be actually to call it a stress response system dysfunction. Now, the adrenals are a piece of that, of course. They are the end organ that starts dumping all the cortisol and adrenaline, which is magical and wonderful. You can't live without it. You need all that hormone when you're presented with a stress or whatever that is, surgery, injury, standing up in public and talking, whatever, right? You need that hormone. But if you're dumping too much of that hormone over time, you're going to get a very predictable set of symptoms that develop because of the wear and tear that hormone causes on the body. The thing is, the adrenals don't call the shots. They're being told to dump that stress hormone. So we have to go up the chain of command here. So we have to go up into the brain, the pituitary, and the hypothalamus. These are hormone-producing glands. They live in the brain. They tell the adrenals what to do. And there's crosstalk. There's negative feedback loops. So if you have some adrenal dysfunction, you are going to have some pituitary and hypothalamic dysfunction as well. But that's only one leg of your stress response. There's a whole other division of your stress response, which is nerves. These are the nerves, though, that control your organs. Technically, this is called the autonomic nervous system. Essentially, two wires from your central nervous system, two wires or nerves to every organ. One's a fight or flight nerve, and one's a rest and digest nerve. And, if a tiger jumps out at you, you want to not only dump cortisol and adrenaline from the hormone side, right? But hormones take time. You need nerves to fire off right away so that you can crank up your heart, your lungs, your sugar metabolism. You need fuel to fight or flee, whichever you're going to do, right? And at the same, so you flip those wires on. At the same time, you flip these other wires off. Things like, ovarian hormones or sperm production or digestive system function or detoxification, like all that stuff that's not really essential when you're dealing with a tiger. Now, I tease these apart. I tease them apart to understand symptoms, because the symptoms are different, hormones versus nerves, right? Treatment is different, hormones versus nerves, but you cannot fully tease these apart because they are intimately connected. You can't affect one without the other. Neither of those systems, though, neither are calling the shots. The CEO of your stress response is actually up a titch higher in the brain. It's called the limbic system, just above the hypothalamus. The limbic system is a regulator, first and foremost, so not a thinking part of your brain, a reacting part of your brain. So it helps with temperature regulation, hot, cold. It helps with sleep-wake cycles, appetite, hunger, stuff like that. It's also the seat of your stress response. In that limbic system is the hippocampus, the amygdala. Its job is to interpret your environment, okay? External environment, internal environment, right? Through perception and sensory nerves, through chemicals in the blood supply. It has to determine, is this stimulus stressful, harmful? Can this kill me? Do I need to jump into fight or flight? Or is it harmless and innocuous and I could chill out like I'm on a beach in Jamaica and let it pass? What happens is that limbic system actually gets trigger happy over time. It gets sensitized. So instead of a minor stressor generating a minor response, minor stressor generates more of a major response, right? And now we end up getting caught in this vicious cycle because of the body overinterpreting its environment as being dangerous. There's very predictable things that happen when the body is dumping all these hormones, right? Dumping all the stress hormones and we're stuck in fight or flight. You're going to see a list of symptoms. And this is conventional research. You'll see fatigue, pain, weight, could be high or low, insomnia, brain fog, anxiety, depression, blood sugar, blood pressure problems. Usually those are low in the beginning. Eventually they go high. Every one of those symptoms at a causal level, you'll see chronic stress, even in conventional research. So what does that sound like? That sounds like a lot. That sounds like all the adrenal fatigue kinds of things. Also sounds like chronic fatigue. Also sounds like chronic pain or fibromyalgia, which is really coming about because of that sensitized system. But really, it's not just a dysfunction with the adrenals. It's a dysfunction with the entire stress response. And when you treat all of that together, that's when people can get better on a very deep level. You know, conventional medicine doesn't really kind of tease, they don't think about it in a holistic way. For some reason, they don't believe that you can have an adrenal problem that is not Addison's disease, which is complete failure, or Cushing's disease, which is because of a pituitary tumor, so you have cranked up hormones. Anything in between means your adrenals are normal. It doesn't make sense to me because there are other glands in the body that can have more subtle dysfunction, not true disease, but dysfunction, whether it's thyroid or ovaries or, you know, pancreas and insulin. Like, you can have pre-disease, but not for the adrenals for some reason. There's never a problem there, right? So even though the symptoms are all the same, right? So the symptoms of adrenal dysfunction are the same as Addison's, just less. So conventional medicine doesn't buy into adrenal fatigue. And they're partially right, but that's a more complex question. Alternative practitioners, they're a little more likely to buy into it and realize that it's a thing, but they're just treating the adrenals. And I'm here to tell you that a little ginseng or rhodiola and a little vitamin C is not going to fix this entirety of your stress response system, the threefold, all your hormones ending in the adrenals, the nerve side of your stress response, and the limbic system. You target all three of those together. That's when the body can shift. And that's when you turn on your body's ability to heal itself. And then you just have to stand back, keep yourself there for long enough, and the symptoms go away. Eventually your strength comes back, your stamina comes back, and you get to live your life again. Now, I know you probably have lots of questions about all that, and there are answers to all those questions, okay? Whether the person in front of you can give you those answers, that's another question, right? I know this is different information, but be open to it because it just might be right. If you have any other questions, you know, go to my website, healing.org, and there's articles, there's links, there's information. You can talk to a patient coordinator to get those questions answered as best we can. Hope this helps. All my best.